Hella, it's 7:01 p.m. Let me tell you about my day today. So I had an appointment to see the doctor, and I was supposed to have him fill out the goddamn paperwork for my back and my knee brace. It wasn't until I got to there that he said, he can't do that. He needs to make an appointment for me with a specialist. He told me on the goddamn phone. But anyway, also, Evan, since he quit football, he was able to go to the doctor. They prescribed him Allegra, which is not covered by insurance. And I can get it cheaper at Walmart than at the stupid pharmacy. But anyway, so I go to pick up Evan. He tells me the pussy principal told him he can no longer use the weight room because he quit football. Now, they let ordinary citizens use that fucking weight room when they want to. So, Monday, I will be calling the superintendent, who was my former vice principal and then principal, to complain about that, because if people in the community can use the fucking weight room, why can't someone who goes to the school use the weight room? And Evan wouldn't have quit football if Sam Houston could get his shit together. But that's not the point of this story. So I've been having cramps like I was going to have diarrhea since Wednesday. So Evan and I were in the room, and I was laying up on that bed, you know, with my hands up and back, because I was so hot. And I was wearing a short sleeve shirt too. You know I'm hot if I'm not wearing a sweatshirt. And right now it's 72 degrees, but back then, I mean, when we went, it was like 68 degrees. Anyway, he walks in and was like, "So you got diarrhea?" I mean, real loud, with the door open. But I think we were the last patients in there before they went to lunch, so nobody else heard. Anyway, then we got the prescriptions, and we went to Walmart. And I got my prescriptions filled. $285 each. I love meeting my deductible. Woohoo! Anyway, so we got my prescriptions, and then there's a new pawn and loan and whatever shop. So it was grand opening today and tomorrow, and so I said, "Well, Evan, let's stop by there before we go home." Oh, I bought myself a cane also, to use in the house or whenever I go outside. So if I feel like I can walk without having to sit down, then I can just use the cane. Anyway, we went to the pawn shop, and I walked in there, and they had, you know, Evan was like, "Look at the rims." They had like 24-inch rims that were $380 for the goddamn rims. But anyway, they had DVDs on, you know, everywhere on both sides of the store. And then on at the back, they had all the musical instruments like guitars and shit. And then I walked in there, and they had all these guns, and, you know, they just look like play guns to me, especially the little 22s that look like a toy gun. And I'm like, "Are those real guns, or are they, like, BB guns?" And he's like, "Oh, these are all real, honey. We don't sell no BB guns here." I'm like, "Okay. I just wanted to know." But they even have a layaway plan, so I might be able to get my laptop after all, because I asked about that. They had They had an HP. They had an HP, and then they had one of those stupid E machines, and then they had something else I've never heard of, and then they had a. I forget what it is when you close it. I can't remember. But that was the one I wanted. And it was actually a tablet or something, but it was only like $200. So anyway, I got my two movies. I got Time Cop and something else. Oh, I got Time Cop and Shawshank Redemption. And Evan got American Psycho and something else. I don't remember the titles. So after that, I said, well, let's go to Foodland to get a Mother's Day card for Nana. So we go there, and Evan is complaining about lifting the walker in and out of the car, and I'm like, fine, I'll just hold your hand when we get there. So let me turn off this air. Do what you're doing, I like the way you do it. Do what you're doing, I like the way you do it. See, that song is going through my head all day, even if I'm not actually listening to it. So anyway, Evan walks me up to the door at Foodland, and then I walk in and I trip over the fucking mat that they have there, the anti-slip. But you know how people sometimes they have the mat folded over, and so I tripped on that and I fell, and I swear every goddamn black person in the tri-state area was there, and I was related to most of them, but my cousin, my aunt, and my cousin's baby daddy were all there, and they're like, okay, everybody's like, are you okay, are you okay, you want me to help you up, you want me to help you up? I'm like, just wait a minute, my son is going to get the electric wheelchair, and when he gets back with it, then he will help me up. So my aunt is like, you just wait until, we get here. So she and my cousin pulled me up by the arms, and Evan lifted me up by the under my rib cage. So then I sat down in there and blah blah blah. So I fell and busted my ass. That's the first time I've ever fallen like in public. I mean, I've fallen down here a lot. But that's the first time I've ever fallen in a store. And, the managers and whatnot kept asking me if I was okay. I knew they were worried that I was litigious, but whatever. So I got home and took my noon meds. It was about 3 o'clock when I got home, so I took my noon meds. New meds and my noon meds, and I just woke up about 10 minutes ago. Well, yeah, it was about 15 minutes ago. So I woke up at like 6:45 or something. So that was my day. Yeah, that's all. I'll talk to y'all later. Pray for me that I stop falling and shit. Bye-bye now.